Hello all, welcome back to Epilepsy Thursdays. And as usual, as I said, throughout the month of November, we are interviewing different epilepsy warriors. And today we have an amazing warrior who has gone through like a lot in her life. And yet she is fighting on and she is a published author, and she has written a new book. Like, her first book was a crime thriller, but her new book is about different epilepsy warriors. We are going to discuss about that as well. She is a single mom. She is fighting it out, and how? पर अगर सब चीजें मैंने ही बता दी तो इंटरव्यू का मजा कहाँ आएगा रे? So here it is, Preeti Singh. Hi, Preeti.
Hi, Ketki. How are you?
I am amazing, awesome as usual. How are you?
I'm so excited. We both are wearing matching blue, and I'm so excited because you are part of my book. And now I'm actually talking to you, and I'm hoping this COVID ends fast and we meet up fast.
Yes, but we will. At least next year to hamari mulaqat honi hai.
Yes, we have to come. I'm going to come to Bombay or you're going to come to Chandigarh. We have to catch up.
Yes, definitely we have to do that. But let's just begin our interview because I have like a ton of questions for you. So shall we just?
Yes, I'm all yours. I'm all yours. Just shoot.
So Preeti, at what age were you diagnosed with epilepsy? ये सवाल मैं हर epilepsy warrior से पूछती हूँ. So at what age were you diagnosed?
I was told that when I was being delivered as a baby, apparently the nurse, some silly nurse, dropped me while during delivery. So she dropped me when I was being delivered. So that caused a brain injury. And but it didn't immediately didn't show as I was a little infant. But 2 years later, while, you know, I was bathing in the tub with my elder sister, I turned blue. And I suddenly got high fever. And then my parents rushed me to the doctor. And then I suddenly had high fever and I suddenly had a seizure. And that's when I was diagnosed at the age of 2. I was diagnosed with epilepsy.
Epilepsy.
So it's been since I was the age of 2, and now I'm 49. Though I behave like I'm 19, but I'm 49. But since the age of 2, I've got epilepsy.
First and foremost, so, you do not look 49. And secondly, one should always be 18 till I die, right? Brian Adams has said, 18 till I die.
I behave like a brat, ask my daughter, she manages me. So, coming back to that, I was diagnosed when I was a baby. So, my parents obviously were very surprised ki kaise ho gaya, kyun ho gaya, typical of that era. But they left no stone unturned in getting all treatments done and everything. It's all mentioned in my book. But they tried everything possible. But since then, I've been taking AEDs, anti-epileptic drugs. So it becomes a way of life. You know, you grow up with the medicines, with the rejection, with the restrictions, with that lifestyle of epilepsy, the stigma, everything. I've been growing up with that as a baby.
So When did you realize, like at what age did you realize that you have epilepsy and it is different and you are different from the so-called normal people? Because 2 साल की उम्र में तो पता नहीं चलता, किसी को समझ में भी नहीं आता. तो आपको कब पता चला कि आपको एपिलेप्सी है और हमें इसके साथ जीना है? At what age did you realize this?
I guess I did not realize the term epilepsy. Maybe it wasn't told to me, because in that era the term itself held a very big stigma, and maybe it was covered up in all wraps. But I knew I was a little different from my sister. I knew I was unwell, because for example in school or even in class or even at home, I was given special permission not to go out and play sports. I was drugged and I was half the time sleeping in class while all my school friends and classmates were doing everything else, and I was half the time drowsy. And my sister was allowed to go for night outs and excursions while I was not allowed. So I knew I was different. And facing the rejection, you know, by my school friends who were a bright and attentive class, where I wasn't, and I would feel very, you know, lost and having the absence attacks. So I kind of faced a lot of rejection in school. So I found my comfort in dolls and things in house. I started naming my toys. I think you all did that.
Yeah.
So I found my comfort in all those things, and I realized that I was different. And but I think that the teenage years came. And I knew that main sabse alag hoon. And I realized that, okay, I have a problem and I'm taking so many medicines. And so I found my, you know, recluse in that. I found my comfort in that. I found my happiness in writing poetry. That's when I started writing poetry. I made a journal, I made a diary. And at the age of 9 was when I started writing my first poem. I was 9 years old.
Okay. Okay. That's quite young.
It started then.
Yeah. So for our audience, उस ज़माने में यानि early 80s, तभी तो दवाइयों के बारे में मतलब अभी भी stigma है, अभी भी taboo है, अभी भी rejection है. तो आप ये सोच सकते हैं for the audience कि अर्ली 80s में कितना ये होगा. अभी भी मेडिसिंस में वी हैवंट प्रोग्रेस सो मच, वेरिन हमारे मेडिसिंस ज्यादा हद तक बहुत मॉडर्न, अभी तो थोड़े फार मॉडर्न है लेकिन तभी बहुत ही अलग हुआ करते थे. तो द स्ट्रगल मस्ट हैव बीन लाइक रियली रियली वियर्ड एंड quite challenging.
Yes, it was very limited, because ek to my father was from the army, so we had only resources in the army. We went from every 2 years we were in a different station. By the time hum ek doctor mein adapt hote the, ek doctor ki treatment mein adapt hote the, we were posted to a different area. Every 2 years there was a new doctor. So by the time I used to get adjusted to a new doctor, there was a new doctor. So each time, but the medicines were always the same. So by the time I used to make new friends, there was a new doctor also. You know, so my doctor was also my new friend.
So yeah, because
it was. So it was very limited. The treatment was very limited. There was always an EEG. There was always an MRI. There were always sodium valproate. There were always the same medicine, the same treatment everywhere, hospital to hospital. I think practically I've got two homes, one home and one OPD.
One hospital.
One hospital and one home. So I've got two homes basically. I know the hospital, the whole corridors, and I know the home. So I just had two homes.
No, because as an army child, as you said, ki posting हमेशा अलग अलग जहाँ पे आपके पापा की posting होगी वहीं पे आपको जाना पड़ेगा, वहीं पे नया doctor आएगा. तो पहले ही आर्मी चिल्ड्रन को दोस्त बनाना बहुत ही मुश्किल हो जाता है. ऊपर से एपिलेप्सी है, तो दोस्तों को आप कैसे समझाती थी कि भाई मुझे एपिलेप्सी है, मुझे अटैक्स आने वाला है, मुझे सीजर्स आने वाले, ये आप उनको कैसे समझाती थी?
मैं समझाती नहीं थी कि somehow I've been very lucky. Some friends would understand. मेरे को उनके सामने होता था, नहीं होता था. Somehow घर में होते थे मेरे को अटैक्स. बाहर सबकॉन्शियस लेवल में बाहर कभी नहीं हुए. Somehow I think subconscious level was alive because हमेशा चीजें घर में हुए. आज तक मेरी वो 4-5 friends है जो आज तक मेरे साथ in connection है. I mentioned about them in the book also. वो आज तक connected है, उन्होंने मेरे seizures देखे हैं. पर कुछ फ्रेंड्स थे जो डिस्टेंट रहे, हमेशा सीजर्स हुए, वो दूर हो गए. आज भी पीपल दे टॉक टू यू आफ्टर सम टाइम एंड 4-5 डेज एंड दे डिसअपीयर फ्रॉम योर लाइफ. बट देयर आर सम पीपल हु आर विद मी सिंस 20 इयर्स. दे आर योर फ्रेंड्स, दे हैव एक्सेप्टेड यू. इट डिपेंड्स फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन. यू कैन नॉट जनरलाइज कि कुछ लोग आप, मेरे को किसी को एक्सप्लेन करने की जरूरत नहीं थी और मैं किसी को एक्सप्लेन भी नहीं करती थी. वो उनके सामने कभी सीजर्स ऐसे हुए भी नहीं, बट वो उन्होंने आई थिंक नेचर देखा या जो भी देखा, वो उन्होंने एक्सेप्ट कर लिया कि जैसे इसको कुछ प्रॉब्लम है. आई थिंक प्रोबेबली मेरा लविंग नेचर इतना था कि मैं फ्रेंडली होती थी सबके साथ, टिफिन शेयर करती थी. मेरा टिफिन खाने जाता, मेरे को कुछ खाने को मिलता नहीं था, मैं उनका खाती थी, वो खाते थे. सो आई गेस माय नेचर वाज सच दैट आई ब्लेंडेड वेरी इजीली विद पीपल.
It's so still
epilepsy never came in between.
Your nature of connecting with people, your nature of connecting with people is still the same. Like fatak se, I still remember our first conversation and it was like
epilepsy never came in between, and it should not come in between. Epilepsy is part of your life. It should not consume your life. It should not be a hawa. कि भाई एपिलेप्सी हो गया तो बस सब कुछ खत्म हो गया. आपको आपकी जिंदगी का एक बहुत माइनर स्कूल पार्ट है. इट शुड नॉट कि एपिलेप्सी हो गया तो आपकी फ्रेंडशिप खत्म हो गई, रिश्ते खत्म हो गए. नहीं, वो तो मेरा एक छोटा सा पार्ट है, एक छोटा सा बॉडी में मेरी जिंदगी का. सो आई नेवर लेट इट. आई वाज लाइक ठीक है तो है, इट्स जस्ट अ स्मॉल पैच इन माई लाइफ. But I live my life bindas. Till now, and I still have to live 40 years more. I'm going to bore you till now. You better interview me when you're 80 and I'm 90.
Done. I hope I stay that long. But if I am, then yes. पता चले 80 और 90 में हम कैसे बातें कर रहे हैं पता नहीं. Dementia हो चुका होगा. दोनों भूल रहे हैं क्या चल रहा है क्या नहीं चल रहा है. So in your introduction, as I said that you are a single mom, तो आपने आपकी बेटी को कैसे समझाया? Like I'm sure as a child she obviously would not understand, but at what age, how old was she, उनकी क्या उम्र थी जब आपने उनको बिठा के समझाया कि बेटा आपके मम्मी को ऐसे ऐसे होता है, इसका मतलब ये है वो है. how did you explain it to her?
Actually she was 6 years old जब हम first time मैं international flight ले रही थी. I was going to US for some family commitment. अपनी मैं ननद के पास जा रही थी. And international flights में 20 hours or 12 hours wait होता है for one connecting flight.
Correct.
So I had to wait from one flight to another flight and at the terminal airport. वो 5-6 साल की थी. Because of my medication, मेरे को नींद आती थी. और it was the first time I was taking an international flight. तो मेरे को आई टाइड हर अपने दुपट्टे से अपने बच्चे को बांध के मैं सोई थी.
हाँ जी बिल्कुल,
दुपट्टे से बाहर के मेरे को कि मैं सो जाऊं मुझे नींद आएगी तो आई होप नोबडी किडनैप्स माय चाइल्ड.
करेक्ट.
आई वाज सो स्केयर्ड टू टेक अ फ्लाइट सो दैट एंड देन शी आस्क्ड मी व्हाई यू टाइम मी अप बिकॉज़ शी ऑलवेज हैड अ फ्री चाइल्डहुड. सो आई टोल्ड हर दिस इज व्हाट विल हैपन टू मामा. मामा मे गेट मामा मे शेक मामा मे फॉल डाउन बिकॉज आई वॉज हैविंग फीलिंग आई वॉज नर्वस टेकिंग अ फ्लाइट. I never sat in an international flight. I did not know what to do. I did not know how to take a flight. And sure enough, in the flight, I had a seizure. First time I had a seizure. And the air hostess took care of my daughter. Because I was getting the order. I was taking the first international flight. The air hostess took care of my daughter in the flight. And the first time I had a seizure. So that is the time she understood. She was just 6-7. Ab uske baad now she manages all my seizures. She sees me. She's written a chapter in the book. How she sees me, how she manages all my... And that's when she decided that she wants to become a doctor.
Oh, okay. So it, like you were her inspiration to become a doctor and...
Inspiration. Not inspiration, I'm a guinea pig. She says, any cheese, I will do autopsy of your brain. she says, main pehle autopsy karoge is brain mein hai kya?
To abhi na, ek aur ek sawal mere man mein aa raha hai. Ki, you have separated from... you have separated from your husband for whatever reason.
Divorce.
Yes. You have divorced from your husband for your personal reasons. Aap alimony nahi leti. Aap khud ke pair pe khadi hain. You are not only a self-made female, but you are taking care of your daughter as well, who's growing up, who's only 20, in her 20s. But you also have an ex-army father who is very old, and you're taking care of him as well. Plus, you are inspiring so many people. Aapne ye strength aati kahan se hai? Where do you get all of this strength from with all of these AEDs and everything? Where aata kahan se hai, Josh bhai?
I think, Keetki, I believe in this line that there's somebody, there's a line, if God puts you into it, he'll put you through it.
God gives you strength to do things.
Yes, I think God gives you strength. The circumstances of my divorce were such that we had a very smooth, amicable divorce, my ex-husband and me. So we did not want it to get very messy. So we had a mutual agreement that he will take care of all the education and financial dealings of my daughter. So he takes care today after a lot of disagreement. He manages my daughter's financial and educational department. And why I have not taken alimony from him is because he wanted to start a new life and he wanted to start from scratch. If I would have taken alimony from him, where would he have started? And I did not want to trouble him. I believe if you have, like, he was the first man I actually truly loved because he married me knowing I had epilepsy. And I said, this is the only gratitude I can give it back to him because he wanted to start a new life. Hamari bani nahi, nahi bani to nahi bani. We were not compatible. It didn't work out. It didn't work out. Nahi likhi thi. It just didn't work out. After 14 years, it didn't work out. So when you love somebody, you let them go. You don't trouble them. You just let them go. And if you don't love them, if you don't tan karo, inko trouble karo, that is not love.
That
is not true love. That is not true love.
That is, I told
the nurses, love you, so I'm letting you go. So he's gone. I said, you go and live your life. So
but
today,
Preeti,
he and me are good friends.
Preeti,
he's the only one who.
He's the only one. Yeah. Continue. Continue. I'll ask the question.
He's the only one who I do fight. We do fight. But if I have a question. If I have any doubts, I call him up and ask him, what do I start? What do I do? I was just 21 when I got married to him. He was the first boyfriend you can say, I had first man in my life. So he was the only man who held me that, yes, I'll marry this epileptic. But to say I'll marry this epileptic, but to actually see me having seizures, to actually go through it is a very different thing. To actually live with an epileptic day to day and watching the seizures and go through the having the medicines and having been drugged and not being able to do the household chores is a very, reality is totally different. So it did not work out. And so when he wanted to go and live a life in the USA, I told him, go. I did not want to. ट्रबल है मुझे 50 लाख दो एक प्रॉपर्टी दो ये दो ऐसे मैंने साथ लेके जाना है आई सेड यू गो यू व्हाट डू यू वांट ही सेड आई जस्ट वांट टू गो टू माइग्रेट टू अमेरिका आई सेड गो आई जस्ट साइन आई सेड जस्ट टेक केयर ऑफ योर डॉटर्स एक्सपेंसेस बाय गॉड्स ग्रेस आई हैव इनफ दाल रोटी खाने के लिए बहुत है रब ने बहुत दिया है
वाहेगुरु जी सो बट द थिंग इज हमेशा ना पैसा ही नहीं कहाँ पे लाइक यू नो इवन दो ही इज टेकिंग केयर फाइनेंशियली व्हिच इज एन ऑसम थिंग क्योंकि बहुत सारे एक्स हस्बैंड्स दे डोंट इवन टेक केयर ऑफ द किड्स सो बाय गॉड्स ग्रेस ही इज डूइंग
दे डोंट
आई मीन आई हैव सीन सो मेनी केसेस वेयर इन दे जस्ट से कि नहीं हमने बच्चे का भी फाइनेंस नहीं लेना है बट इट्स नॉट ओनली अबाउट मनी
एंड माय डॉटर And my daughter, she goes to America. She spends her holidays with him.
So that's
she
a lovely
goes,
relationship.
She spends her holidays with him. Yeah, and whenever I have any problem, medical problem, any, he always gives a call. Any problem, you need any money, he's always in crisis. He's a call away. We don't talk daily. There is no I love you. There is no, you know, he's whenever he comes to India, we go out for dinner like a family, three of us. But that's it. We are very formal. But there is no dirt between us. There is no gali galoch. There is no hatred. We are like friends now.
Cordial and everything.
Yeah, we are peaceful. There is peaceful.
But
there
you
is
know,
total peace. वो एक 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 life का chapter था जो खत्म हो गया. It's finished. And it was a beautiful chapter. It was वो हमने बहुत लड़ाई झगड़ा किया उसमें कुछ नहीं मिला कुछ नहीं रखा खत्म हो गया Now our aim is just to raise the daughter both with father and mother's love, get her married, make her a doctor, and just lead our own separate lives. He can get married, I can get married, no issue.
That is such a beautiful place that you are right now. This is such a beautiful relationship that has happened right now. But Preeti ji, it's not always about money. It is what I meant was
yes.
ki ye jo inspiring strength hota hai na, bahut bari kya hota hai after a divorce ya after like, you know, after a broken relationship as well. Divorce ki to baat chodo. सादा किसी का ब्रेकअप भी हो जाता है तो डिप्रेशन में जाते हैं लोग दे फील सैड अबाउट इट बट विद एपिलेप्सी विद एन एलिंग एंड एजिंग फादर जिनका आपको ख्याल रखना पड़ता है बिकॉज ही इज वेरी ओल्ड नाउ उनके साथ भी उनका ख्याल जो इमोशंस होते हैं उनके साथ जीते जीते भी आप दूसरों को इंस्पायर कर रहे हैं ये वाली स्ट्रेंथ कहाँ से आती है ये मेरा सवाल था
इट इज I think somebody, they are, it's like a candle passing on Ketki. Somebody, I meet people in daily life, somebody inspires me, inspire people. It's not bad. It's, yes, my father is 83. He is also aging. But in daily life, I watch him. And वो मतलब छोटी छोटी बातों में वो नहीं पेपर अपने आप उठाएंगे अपने शूलेस खुद बांधेंगे छोटी छोटी चीजें and I watch him. I said, इस उम्र में भी खुद छोटे he will not he's like a soldier I will not give up. तो मैं उनको देखती हूँ and I get I said, इस उम्र में भी वो खुद अपनी चीजें करते रहेंगे I am there you know I you have to I am with an ailment I've got diabetes I'm a heart patient also I've had so many surgeries in my body.
That is my next question actually. That is my next question. My next question
I know the backside of the operation. I know the backside of the operation theater also. The surgeons are Ajo, madam, Ajo. Mera to uterus mein nikal gaya hai. I get and all the women get jealous of me because I don't get any periods also. You also get jealous of me, I'm sure.
Yes. Hamari baat bhi hui thi. I was so jealous of you. I was like, you don't get periods and every month bloody beef we get periods. And periods ke time mein jo apne ek hormones bhangra karte rehte hain और उसमें सीजर्स आ ही जाते हैं invariably every female has to go through that
when my daughter was born उस टाइम मेरा हैमरेज हो गया then I was in coma for 7 days फिर मेरा gall bladder stones remove हुआ है फिर मेरा uterus remove हुआ है फिर मेरा पता नहीं क्या क्या अंदर से सब कुछ गायब है मैं body donation भी करूँ तो कुछ बचा ही नहीं donate करने को
Like you have been through so much since you were a child. You have experienced so many things जो शायद हम ये platform पे नहीं बात कर पाएंगे जो personally हमें पता है शायद ये platform पे हम उन चीजों के बारे में नहीं बात कर पाएंगे या फिर whatever it is if you're comfortable if you're not comfortable it's up to you. As a child, you have been through a lot of things that हम ये कहेंगे कि भाई हमारे दुश्मन को भी ये ना सहना पड़े फिर आपके इतने ऑपरेशंस हुए हैं आपके आपके साथ इतना सब कुछ हुआ है बट वॉट कीप्स यू गोइंग ये जो आपका कल होना हो ये जो आपकी एक फेमस लाइन है
जो आई जस्ट फील कि एक मेरे अंदर एक फायर है एक पैशन है फॉर एग्जांपल यू इंस्पायर मी यू आल्सो इमेजिन यू हैव फिर भी यू गेट अप एंड यू स्टार्ट मेकिंग अनदर चैनल यू मेक अनदर यूट्यूब वीडियो दैट इज इंस्पायरिंग इट इज आई मीन ईच एपिलेप्सी वॉरियर इंस्पायर्स मी आई मीन दे आर There are just 8 of you in my book, but there may be so many out there. I mean, give up nahi karna hai. Every day, you have to just accept your life the way it is. You have to accept it. Acceptance is the key. Ye likhi thi, hamari life mein likhi. It could have been worse. We could have been lying, Lola, Langara, so many epileptic. We could have been, just lying in the ward somewhere and all this, with so many seizures. Multiple times in the day. Once I had 7 seizures in a day. I mean, and now, lately, I mean, it's been 3 years in the gap. I mean, I've had not for 3 years. Now my medicines are being reduced.
That is
so luckily, I mean, it's everything, when you see everything as a blessing. The reason I decided to write this book was because there's a friend of mine She lost her son due to sudden death. I was planning to write a love story. You know, at the age of 48, I fell in love with a man who was 50 years old.
But that is so amazing, right? Because people have this stigma. people have this stigma in their heads ki like you know प्यार करने की खाली एक ही उम्र होती है, उसके बाद आप प्यार नहीं कर सकते. ये कुछ अजीब और गरीब तरीका पता नहीं. You can fall in love.
प्यार किया नहीं जाता डार्लिंग, हो जाता है, बस हो जाता है. अगर अगर प्यार प्लान करके किया जाए तो वो प्यार नहीं, वो मैनिपुलेशन होता है ना, कि मैंने उससे प्यार करना है, फिर वो तो मैनिपुलेशन हुआ. प्यार तो हो जाता है, बस हो जाता है. मेरे को भी प्यार हो गया था, मैंने पहले प्लान किया, हो गया, पर हो गया, पर मैंने रियलाइज किया कि सही जगह नहीं हुआ भैया, सॉरी गलती से मिस्टेक हो गया. गलती से मिस्टेक हो गया, फिर मैंने विड्रॉ कर लिया. फिर मैंने विड्रॉ कर लिया क्योंकि the person was already in line of control, was already belonging to somebody else.
Oh no no, गलती से हो जाता है भाई, ऐसे तो मतलब हर एक के साथ होता है. No matter what age.
That is an unexpected death in epilepsy.
या हाय प्रीति. सो थोड़े टेक्निकल इश्यूज की वजह से थोड़ा सा गड़बड़ हो गई थी, बट वी आर बैक. सो यस, यू वर सेइंग प्यार तो कभी भी हो सकता है,
कभी भी और किसी के साथ भी.
हाँ जी,
अगर तो हम सोच के प्यार करें कि नहीं इसके साथ करना है उसके साथ करना है, तो वो मैनिपुलेशन हुआ.
करेक्ट.
प्यार, यू जस्ट हैपन टू फॉल इन लव. And somehow the cosmos, I believe, cosmos plays a very vital role and the universe makes it happen. And but yes, if you feel it is disturbing somebody's life, then I think you should take a step back. And that's what I did. And I took a step back because when I realized it is, I realized I fell in love with somebody who was not available, who was already separated, not totally single. So I came back and I realized, I said no. And then I realized I was going to write a book on my so-called falling in love with a separated man. But then I realized then my friend's son passed away due to SUDEP. So I realized SUDEP is sudden unexpected death in epilepsy. So maine socha ki aaj, he was just 28 years old. So I realized, I said, kal to it can be me also, it can be any of the epilepsy warriors. So I said, kal bulawa aane se pehle is pe ek book likh dete hain. So that's how this book was conceived. And I must take a moment to thank Diva Tandon here. Actually, she was the one who got most of the epilepsy warriors in touch with me. But she could not be part of this book because she had other projects in mind. She had to do some other, her own projects. But
Diva Tandon from Kolkata, right?
Yeah. So she was initially part of the book, but she had to break away. Yeah.
So
she,
for the
she
audience,
got everybody in touch.
So for the audience, Diva Tandon is an amazing epilepsy warrior from Kolkata, who talks and who spreads awareness not only about epilepsy but also about yoga. So
yoga.
Yes. So you can find and you can read about her story, not in this book, unfortunately. We are going to talk about this book though. But if you want to know about her story, you can check out the Instagram page called Accept Epilepsy. Or वहाँ पे Diva
and Home Yoga. Home Yoga.
Home Yoga. Yes. So you can find and you can read a thoda sa part of her story on the page Accept Epilepsy, which is available on Instagram. So you can know more about Diva. So yes, coming back to you, Preeti. आपकी सबसे पहली जो किताब थी, The first, when you became a published author, was a crime thriller.
Yeah.
But now, you are writing a non-fictional story, and it is a collaboration with so many different epilepsy warriors. What made you write this book? What made you think that, no, I have to get everyone together and create a compilation of all the warriors that are there? What made you write this and completely break the genre that you were in previously?
See, our first book was Flirting with Fate, and it's a crime thriller because while I was growing up, initially, like every girl was growing up, you know, with Mills and Boons, and the Prince Charming will come on a white horse, and I'm the princess and damsel in distress, you know, in my castle, because I was an epileptic and always being high makidar phasgay types. And my husband came and took me and the Prince Charming. But when the marriage broke, I said, kithe Prince Charming? Kahan gaya Prince Charming? So all the romance books went on in the dustbin. And then came out all the crime novels, the Nancy Drews and Hardy Boys. So I, in the college, was all Nancy Drews and how to catch the bad guys. So my husband suddenly became the bad man, you know. So then I started writing. I got into the crime patrol and Savdhan India, you know. Slowly, I wanted to watch Sherlock Holmes and everything. And somehow I started developing that, you know, I was very keen to catch all the bad guys. And then the idea came to write Flirting with Fate. I went to Shimla. I stayed there for 3 months. It's a book based in the 80s. And it's got an award also, Flirting with Fate. So it's based in 80s about, it's a psychological thriller. So I wrote Crossroads, which is based on my life. I wanted to write something. There was a fire inside me to write, and I was not at peace with myself. I wanted to write. It was a catharsis. It had to come out. So after writing Crossroads, which was based on my life, what I had gone through, I became much at peace with myself. That time I was going through my divorce. And then my third book was Watched, again a crime thriller, which was again based in Chandigarh. And then this book, the love story, which was to be, which had never happened. Then I realized, I was very desperate to write this book very fast, because during writing this book, I underwent 2 surgeries. So I was like, oh God, Yamaraj is coming. I'm going to die.
You're not dying anytime soon, because we have to do that interview jab aap 90 years ki hai aur main 80 years ki hu, aur hum pata nahi wo funny video hone wala hai, because both of us are going to go insane by then.
You have to ask, you have to talk to my publisher every week. Renu, publish fast. I'm going to die. You don't know how many biopsies I've gone through. Kabhi breast ka biopsy, kabhi pancreas ka biopsy, kabhi kisi cheez ka biopsy. Mere ko biopsy idhar dard ho raha hai, udhar dard ho raha hai. Mujhe har cheez ka cancer ka biopsy ho gaya tha. Because during the making of this book, because I thought, mujhe to bulawa aa gaya, mata ne bulaya hai. So I thought I'm going to go. But this book had to come out. But because my biggest fan is Yamaraj.
No. Yamaraj kuch nahi. Yamaraj is only telling you कि भाई जिद पकड़ के है कि घंटी बजा रहे हैं, फिर आपको वापस बुला रहे हैं, आपको बस बता रहे हैं कि नहीं बाबा, आपको जल्दी जल्दी ये कर वो कर. आपकी बकेट लिस्ट भी बहुत बड़ी है, तो हमें कुछ आपकी बकेट लिस्ट के बारे में बताइए प्लीज.
आप तो बकेट लिस्ट बहुत बड़ी है मेरी. आप तो यमराज को भी घंटी बजानी है मैंने.
तो कुछ चीजें बताइए आपके बकेट लिस्ट में से जो आपको करनी है.
ओह, आई वांट टू क्लाइम अ माउंटेन. आई रियली वांट टू क्लाइम अ माउंटेन. एंड इफ माय डॉक्टर सेज यस, बट डॉक्टर को भी पटा लूंगी, डोंट वरी. आई हैव टू क्लाइम अ माउंटेन. उसको मैंने, आई हैव टू जस्ट समहाउ, यू नो, जस्ट एंड ट्रैवल अलोन. एक्चुअली माय मोबाइल, आई गेट अ सेंसेशन ऑफ अ सीजर इफ माय मोबाइल वाइब्रेट्स. आई हैव टू गेट ओवर दैट फियर. So I have to, a friend of mine told me, when you have to get over a fear, go through it. So I need to get over that fear of a mobile vibrating. And the bucket list for ye bhi, I want to open a small company where only I have to have epileptics, employ only epileptics, maybe make t-shirts for epileptics, or maybe make a bracelets for epileptics, something, a small little, or also in the bucket list is open a little house for stray dogs, something like that. But I don't have the resources, but mind me to hai ye sab baate. I also want to do bungee jumping from the topmost height, you know, bungee jumping, topmost. Ek bucket list mein ye bhi hai, go to the topmost, shayad Red Fort ke upar ya sabse upar, and stand in the Titanic pose, you know. And maybe shayad wahan main single malt khol ke pee lo puri bottle. Maybe for somebody who...
Someone
who accepts me like the way I am, you know, just the way I am. Jalli, total pagal.
I'll be there with you. Dono share karenge wo single mold. Tension na le.
Haan, bas.
Humne puri neat. Humna khatam karna hai.
Puri neat. Pura neat. And I want to just shout across the whole world, you know, that bas, I just drank the whole bottle. Because doctors will not allow me to drink.
Yeah,
to break all the barriers. Break all the barriers. Mm-hmm. Do all the pagalpanti.
Haanji, bilkul. For the audience, bahut bari kya hota hai? Doctors do not allow people with epilepsy to drink. Kyunki daru jo hoti hai, wo shayad humare medicines ke saath kuch alag ye kar jaye. Opposite reaction ho jaye jiski wajah se seizures aate hain, par iska matlab ye nahi ki aap daru nahi pee sakte. Main to peeti hu, main to beer peeti hu, whiskey sab peeti hu main, par usse pehle aap ek bari aapke doctor se permission le jaye. Kuch bhi cheez karni ho wo agar hum had se zyada kare to obviously uska it is going to have a negative effect. कुछ ज्यादा पानी पिए तो उसके भी साइड इफेक्ट्स होते हैं. तो कोई भी चीज हद से ज्यादा ना करे, बट एक हाथ ड्रिंक चल जाती है. तो आप ऐसे ना कर टेंशन ले कि भाई दारू पिए, ओ माय गॉड. दारू गलत बात नहीं है, हद से ज्यादा पीना गलत बात है. तो यस, हम तो पटियाला मारने वाले हैं जाके टाइटैनिक के साथ. हम खड़े, मैं खड़ी हूँ टाइटैनिक के साथ.
टाइटैनिक पोज.
यस, आई विल बी देयर विद यू. सो बट प्रीति, आई एम रियली वेरी सॉरी टू टेल यू दिस दैट आई एम बीटिंग यू बिफोर विद दैट ऑल मर्चेंडाइज, क्योंकि हम नेक्स्ट ईयर ही एक्सेप्ट एपिलेप्सी के मर्चेंडाइज लॉन्च कर रहे हैं. सो
not only t-shirts,
every merchandise possible with an identity bracelet and everything. Okay. we are launching next year. So even
okay,
for the audience,
good.
Stay tuned. We have
okay,
to do that
good.
Right. Yes, we have
yes,
to spread
yes.
awareness as much as possible.
Yes.
And एक बारी हो जाए वो सारी चीजें, it is in process, एक बारी हो जाए तो आपके पास तो वो हैम्पर पहुंचना ही है, तो टेंशन ना लीजिए.
मेरा हाँ वही मैंने लिखा था, मेरा one aim is from 3XL I have to come back to medium size. मेरे लिए 3XL ready रखना. My size is huge. that is one of my bucket list, to come down from 3XL to medium size. वो पता नहीं होगा कि नहीं होगा. पूरी गोल मटोलू
नहीं, पर वो तो क्या हमारे एंटी एपिलेप्टिक ड्रग्स की वजह से होता ही है ना. मैं तो अभी XXS हो गई हूँ. मेरा वजन तो इतना कम हो गया है कि मेरी रिलेटिव्स मुझे बोलने लगे हैं कि भाई तू और ज्यादा अगर पतली हो जाएगी ना तो तू डिसअपियर होने वाली है. तो मैं उल्टे, मतलब मैं दूसरे स्पेक्ट्रम में हूँ. मैं इनविजिबल होते जा रही हूँ अभी.
आई नो, लाइक गोल मटोल भाई, खाते पीते घर के लगने चाहिए ना. हम लोग तो पंजाबियाँ, सिखनी लगनी चाहिए खाते पीते घर की.
पर ये हमारे मेडिसिंस की वजह से भी तो होते हैं वेट इश्यूज बहुत सारे.
एंड ड्यू टू माय हिस्टेरेक्टोमी ऑपरेशन आई हैव पुट ऑन वेट, दो दैट्स नो एक्सक्यूज. आई नो दैट.
नो, इट्स नॉट अबाउट द एक्सक्यूज, बट इट इज अ फैक्ट ना. वी कैन नॉट डिनाई दैट फैक्ट, है कि नहीं?
यस,
वी कैन नॉट जस्ट डिनाई दैट. वी हैव टू, एज यू सेड, वी हैव टू एक्सेप्ट इट एंड मूव ऑन. So, you have a list of so many people who have epilepsy. You run a WhatsApp support group, and there are a lot of people.
I have a separate mobile and a separate number just for, ever since I started writing this book, just for epileptics who reach out, because they are so scared to come on Facebook. They're scared to even like my statuses. But they want to inbox and they want to talk. They just want to share. They want to talk that they have epilepsy. Kabhi kisi family member mein beti ko hai and usko epilepsy hai, par wo baat karna chahti, par mummy papa wo uske dreams hai, uske sapne hai. Kabhi main bhi aisi thi, par koi baat karne wala nahi tha. And it can be suicidal. She can get into depression. So she wants to talk to me. So I have this WhatsApp number. I have this, and I said, you just talk to me. I said, do not pick up a rope and kill yourself. Please don't do that. I am not a counselor, Ketki. I am not a psychologist, but I can talk. I am a 50-year-old woman. At least I can. I love talking. Tum bas phone uthao, beta, mujhse baat karo. Koi galat step mat lena. Sometimes you cannot talk to your mummy, papa.
Correct.
You know, she, and there was this girl, for example, she was an epileptic and she had a boyfriend. And उसने गलती से बॉयफ्रेंड को बता दिया कि आई एम एन एपिलेप्टिक. बॉयफ्रेंड एक्सेप्टेड हर, बट हिज पेरेंट्स वुड नॉट एक्सेप्ट हर.
अयो,
यू नो, एंड शी, हर पेरेंट्स हैड टोल्ड हर, बताना मत किसी को, लोग क्या कहेंगे. सबसे बड़ा, लोग क्या कहेंगे, लोग
ये लोग क्या कहेंगे, मतलब लोग ही आके आपका घर संसार चला रहे हैं, ऐसे लगने लगता है. सो हाउ डिड
उसको मैं, so I've been counseling her, trying to tell her to be brave, trying to talk to her. She was at the stage where she was going to kill herself. Like, मैं ये खा लूंगी. मेरा भी स्टेज था कभी लाइफ में. मैंने भी खूब फिनेल खाई है, मैंने भी अपने रिस्ट काटे, मैंने सब कर चुकी हूँ. साला यमराज ही मुझे लेके नहीं जाता है.
क्योंकि आपका टाइम ही नहीं आया यमराज, आपको कब से कह रहे मुझे,
मुझे ये लिखना था, मुझे ये लिखना था, मुझे ये लिखना था.
सिर्फ ये नहीं, आपकी बकेट लिस्ट पूरी कंप्लीट होगी तभी यमराज आएंगे.
होनी है अभी, बकेट लिस्ट पूरी होनी है. आई हैव टू बी द टाइटैनिक पोज.
करेक्ट.
आई डन ऑल क्रेजी थिंग्स. But the, I mean, I so I talk to these people, and if somebody needs me, but yes, I'm running this WhatsApp group. I'm talking to, it's not easy to deal with people's, we all epileptics have, due to our medicines, we have our mood swings. You are aware of it.
Yes.
We have our mood swings. We have our temper tantrums. We have that, but it's okay. That's where you understand each other.
Correct.
You know, we have our, yeah, it's okay. That's what is compassion about.
Correct. And since we have been through that, we can help the other person as well.
Exactly.
Like, if you see this tattoo, if you can see this tattoo.
Yes. What does this mean?
It's a semicolon. Like,
what do the two drops mean? What do they mean?
No, it's not a two drop. It's a semicolon. Yeah. It's the other
okay,
one
okay.
is a,
yeah.
It's yeah. a semicolon. So semicolon means, like, you know, like you authors, writers, you can stop a sentence, but you decide not to stop the sentence and continue. And that is exactly what a semicolon tattoo means, where you can stop your life but you decide not to. So I have been right. through the same thing that you're talking. Of course, I've spoken about it as well, where, you know, you end up trying to do things and whatever. But today it's about you, so I'm not getting into my story. So when you, I exactly know how it feels to cut our wrists and harm ourselves, but what made you, what was that emotion when you woke up, when you came back? Because it's that one moment which makes us want to harm ourselves. And later on, we are like, no, we are not doing that. We are done doing that and we are going to get up and start doing something else. So what was that one thought that went into your head every single time that you harmed yourself and you came out of it? What was that moment when you switched?
There were two moments. One which got me very down when I was a 15-year-old girl. I was almost molested. I have no qualms in sharing. I was almost molested during a seizure while having tuitions.
Okay.
So ye kisi bhi ladki ke saath ho sakta hai. I have mentioned it in my book, and it can be most girls who are epileptics or non-epileptics may be going through it. Girls who are listening to this video, please be brave. Please don't hide from your parents. Please talk to them. Please share with your parents. Sadly, most molesters are in the house, relatives. For me, my molester was my tutor. My tutor was my molester. I was just 15 years old. He tried molesting me. He was an old man. And he tried molesting me while I was about to have a seizure. He didn't completely molest me, but he saw the signs it was coming. And later but that got me, started making me stammer. That's when the journey of my stammering began. Main haklana shuru ho gaya mera. I was a very bright student till then. I was taking part in elocutions and up and about in studies. Main bilkul sehm si gayi. उसके बाद मेरे को आदमियों से डर लगना शुरू हो गया, बॉयज से डर लगना शुरू हो गया. उससे पहले मैं I was always very friendly with boys. That was the first wrong touch by a man.
And a wrong touch always ends up making a person feel like, you know, even when even one of the videos I had said that even when a person decides to have sex, if you have it with the wrong person, you have that sex ke bare mein bhi aapke wrong motions shuru ho jate hain. So did you go through that as well, especially when you were fighting with epilepsy and intimacy being a problem because of the wrong touch?
No, the first intimacy I had was with my husband only. There was love always there. But the fears of that first experience of that tutor was so much on my mind. It was, you know, it was always so scary. My husband was very gentle, was very, you know, trying to make me understand everything. But, you know, he tried his best. You know, we tried to make our marriage work. But that was like kind of a black cloud always on my mind. When the second incident that happened to me was a servant. When my daughter was about 6 months old, my husband was on Kargil duty. A servant tried to molest me when I was breastfeeding my daughter. He walked into the room and he tried molesting me. And वो देखकर ही मेरे को सीजर हो गया. एंड आई हैड अबाउट 3-4 सीजर्स रिपीटेडली. उसने कभी जिंदगी में सीजर कभी देखा नहीं था, तो शायद वो देखकर वो और घबरा गया और मेरी बेटी रो पड़ी. अब आप मुझसे अभी केत की सवाल पूछ रहे थे, व्हाट वाज दैट वन मोमेंट दैट चेंज माय माइंड. अब मेरे हाथ में 6 महीने की बेटी है. एंड आई रियलाइज उस मोमेंट में woman in me, that when I got up from my seizures, I had realized I had forgotten to close the main door because of my memory lapses. And I'd been so casual about my medications because I was more of a mother and I'd forgotten about my medications. Us moment mein mere andar mother jaag gayi ki now I have to protect my daughter. After all, he's a man. A man can molest my daughter also.
Yes.
That is when the mother in me woke up. I said, now I have to stop living like a woman. I have to start living like a mother. I have to start protecting my child. And that's when I started became very, very careful about my medications.
I mean, this is something which not only happens with people with epilepsy, but anywhere in the world, every female faces this. Like any woman can face this to anyone.
Any woman with any disability or any woman without a disability.
Correct.
Any woman, any time can face this. But I was more vulnerable because I was after a seizure, you're so weak. I could not fight back. But after that, mere andar wo fire hui that now I will not tolerate anybody. I have to protect my child. And that's why when you see my wall, I'm always fighting against rapists. I'm always propagating. I'm always, because I've almost undergone rape. I know the feeling.
What would you tell all the females? It doesn't, regardless whether you have disability, you don't have disability, it doesn't matter. What would you tell the girls out there, the young girls out there? Like, you know, if you are a mature woman, a female can feel weird. But jo young girls hai, jo molest hote hai, ya phir, you know, wrong touch hota hai, ya phir get raped. What would you tell them? Like, you know, bahut bari wo ghar jaake batati bhi nahi hai ki kuch aisa hua hai. So what would you tell them? What would their first reaction should be? Like, what should they do?
See, first I will say, abuse is not only physical. It starts with emotional abuse. Slowly, emotional abuse leads to physical abuse. It starts with manipulation, emotional abuse. When you see the red signs, the red flags leave. When you see the first lie leave, protect yourself. I tolerated for a long, long time. Maybe I tolerated as a mother. Maybe I tolerated because mujh mein shayad himmat nahi thi. But do not stay where you are being tolerated. Stay where you are wanted.
Respect
yourself. Stay where you are respected. Yes, stay where you are respected and wanted. I mean, today I am proud the way I have brought up my daughter. I have not, mujhe usko duniyadari jyada aati hai, mujhe nahi aati hai. Maine usko utha ke swimming pool mein phenk diya. Ja, tu ja ke mar. I said, teri maa bimar hai, bhaiya. I said, teri maa to bimar hai. Your father is gone. Manage your life. My daughter knows how to manage herself. वो जाके सड़क पे जाके थप्पड़ मार देगी भैया लोग को. She goes and sorts people out.
That is an amazing.
And she knows how to. Today she knows that mama conks off. She can manage her own life. She knows the bank. She knows everything. She's 22. I've trained her in such a manner that tomorrow if I fall sick, I get admitted, she knows what to do. She's driving. She's managing. More than young girls, they're so dependent on mummy, papa, kidhar hai. She is like, I've trained her, your mother is half dead, your father is not there. So please live on your own.
What would your advice be to the mothers like, you know, there are so many mothers out there, especially young mothers, like who are in their early 20s or like, you know, 30s. What would your advice be to those mothers who have epilepsy? How to raise their children? Like, what is the advice that you would give them?
Prepare your children. Prepare your children that you have a problem. Even the children who have epilepsy, for the mothers also, I would tell them, please, unki unpe ye stigma, unpe ye hawa mat daliye ki tum bimar ho. Wo chota sa hai aspect. Unme they are, every child is gifted. Even the mothers are gifted. You don't have to be ashamed of your mother. There's so much more to, of all of us epileptics, we are gifted. Epilepsy is just a small part of us. It is like diabetes or heart attack or cancer. There's so much more to us that we can give to the world. I've got such a volume of love inside me. I'm dying to pour it on people.
Oh, you do,
nobody
you
comes,
do.
Nobody comes to my house or nobody has, I'm known as Lady Santa. Nobody goes without a gift. All of you have received a gift from me.
We received an amazing gift. And this is so pretty. This is so pretty. Like, you know, Diwali gift. Oh, maine ulta pakda, sorry. Diwali gift with personalized keychains. And it is so pretty.
So we all have something in us. Jab Bhagwan kuch leta hai, to andar kuch dal ke deta hai. So please enhance everybody. Everybody is gifted. You just have to unwrap the person. Every human being is gifted.
Correct. But aap kya salah denge jo young mothers hai jinko epilepsy hai, matlab especially jo mothers hai unko epilepsy hai ki ha theek hai bacche ko epilepsy hai to mom dad like, you know, they take care of the child, they leave no stone unturned. Of course they feel helpless as well ki hum kuch kar nahi pa rahe, whatever. But jinko mothers especially jinko epilepsy hai, to aap unko kya salah denge ki apne bacche ko kaise samjhaye ki bhai aap kaise unko bataye ki mujhe epilepsy hai, mujhe seizures aane wale hai. Ye salah
They can make charts. If the child is too small, they can make charts, they can show them visuals, they can show them, educate the child that this is not a stigma, koi buri baat nahi hai, juta sunghana mat kijiye, all those myths se hataiye. Everything is so modern now. Please unko educate kijiye, remove them from the age-old myths, educate them, take them out and tell them all the first, most importantly, get a dog. Children connect easily with dogs. Dogs always tell before a seizure is about to come. Kids always connect very warmly with dogs. Always, you know, and the mothers can always, if they have a partner, they have a husband who's very caring, if they have family members can always prepare the children. They can, you know, make it a family discussion. You don't have to scare the child. You know, you have to prepare the child.
I love the idea about those charts and everything. I really like that. I should be talking about it in one of the next videos.
You know,
I love a child idea.
A child understands diagrams. You can make diagrams, you can make paintings, you can make drawings and make a child understand that way. Ki aisa mummy gir sakti hai. Ha, through pictures. You can make them understand. You can show them movies. That movies mein aisa hota. You can show them trailers. It's all right. You know, the children are not dumb these days. Children are very smart. They understand everything.
Correct.
Children are not stupid.
Abhi hamara na interview kuch zyada hi serious ho gaya hai. To main... I just lighten it up. I want to know, you know, jaise aapne myths ke bare mein abhi baat ki, ki like juta sungana or whatever.
Yeah, this is Sizzla. For the audience, he also has epilepsy.
Sizzla. Oh, Sizzla
also has epilepsy. and I adopted him from the road. He was he was abandoned by two homes because he has epilepsy.
Oh.
So every morning he has anti-epileptic drugs. I also have it. And he has in half a piece of egg.
With the
drugs. मतलब मेरे को बाथरूम भी जाने नहीं देता बाथरूम के दरवाजे पे पॉ करता था जल्दी निकलो इज एक्स्ट्रा पोजेसिव मतलब हस्बैंड हो तो ऐसा हो इवन इफ आई गेट अ फोन कॉल ही विल कीप पॉइंग मी हु आर यू टॉकिंग टू यू नो आई मीन वांट यू हैव अ गाय हु इज एज पोजेसिव एज हिम यू नो
एज केयरिंग आई वुडंट यूज द वर्ड पोजेसिव बट एज केयरिंग एज हिम The possessive guys can be very toxic. So possessive, they caring.
Malav, he will put his head on my shoulder and keep looking at me like that. You know that I wish you know that those eyes and those imploring eyes at me. You know like that. Hi, that well, you are my whole and soul and that type. You know.
That's caring. So as I was saying on a lighter note. हमें कभी भी कहीं पर भी सीजर आ जाती है तो ऐसा कुछ फनी इंसिडेंट आपके साथ हुआ है जहाँ पे लाइक यू नो यू हैव हैड अ सीजर एंड कोई कुछ भी फनी जूता सुनाने आ गए लाइक मेरे साथ ऐसे हुआ था कि एक ने मुझे ऐसे उठा दिया लाइक आई वॉज एक्सपीरियंसिंग अ सीजर एंड ही वॉज अ 6 foot टॉल गाय लाइक अ फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन like known friend very like safe environment mein lekin he was seeing my seizure for the first time to unhone mujhe aise kuch na ajeeb tarike se ab main to hu tingu 5 feet tall he was a 6 foot tall giant and a pixie so he picked me up in such a way that mujhse hansi chhoot gayi to seizure ke beech mein main hans bhi rahi hu aur mujhe seizure bhi aa raha hai so it was a very funny incident तो आपके साथ कुछ ऐसे मिथ या फिर अनियन सुंगाना ऐसे कुछ अजीब और गरीब फनी कुछ इंसिडेंट हुआ है आपके साथ
फनी नहीं हुआ बट आई वोंट कॉल इट फनी बट एक्चुअली व्हेंस माय हस्बैंड माय डॉटर एंड मी वर वाचिंग द मूवी सुपरस्टार एंड वी वर वाचिंग एंड इट हैड दिस फ्लैशिंग लाइट्स इन इट एंड वी हैड दिस बकेट ऑफ पॉपकॉर्न इन इट यू नो वी वर हैविंग पॉपकॉर्न एंड Suddenly, I had the seizure. The popcorn went like the duck, 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 duck. In the whole complete dark hall, suddenly the popcorn went upper niche. So I don't know what the half the people must be thinking. What my husband and me were up to during the in the hall. but until
no, we cannot talk about adult things like that.
But we had to just calm them down. That we had to calm them down. She's having a seizure, you know.
No, but yes, for the audience, strobe lights की वजह से जैसे हमने already पहले भी बात कर चुके हैं कि lights, audio और video sensory की वजह से seizures आते हैं. मुझे भी बहुत सारे फिल्म्स में सीजर्स आ चुके हैं बाय वॉचिंग लाइक यू नो स्पेशली द स्ट्रोब लाइट्स एंड उसकी वजह से नाउ द मेन थिंग दैट वी कम टू इज द बुक यस टेल अस अबाउट द बुक लाइक इन डिटेल
यू कैन सी द बटरफ्लाइज I wanted butterflies in the title because we all are hiding in a cocoon most of our lives. And I wanted us, most of epileptics, to come out of their cocoons and fly as butterflies. And that's what I think, you know, that's 8 of us are doing right now. We've come out as butterflies. And I just want all of us, 8 of us, to motivate others to come out of the cocoon. Niklo bahar. Kuch josh se niklo, bahar niklo, kisi aur ki madad karo. And believe me, throughout this journey, so many have reached out to me on my phone, quietly. And I would like to take names. Some are still driving on the quiet. They're doing jobs on the quiet. They don't want to tell. They want to hide completely the identity. बट मजबूरी है, बट यू नो वो चुपचाप कर रहे हैं, किसी को जॉब की प्रॉब्लम है, किसी को ड्राइविंग की प्रॉब्लम है, बट दे आर रिस्किंग देयर लाइव्स, बट एटलीस्ट दे आर रीचिंग आउट, एटलीस्ट दे आर टॉकिंग, वो कहीं ना कहीं से अब निकल तो रहे हैं, बाहर निकल रहे हैं, इतना ही मेले बहुत है, धीरे धीरे निकल रहे हैं. सो आई एम जस्ट होपिंग धीरे धीरे रेवोल्यूशन तो होगा,
वो तो
एटलीस्ट इट्स अ स्टार्ट.
हमने तो शुरू कर ही दिया है, हम दोनों ने तो शुरू कर ही दिया है.
I am very excited about the cover. You know, it's not a drab brain type of electrical kind of a medical cover. I wanted something like, you know, kuch kuch that kya dilwale dulhaniya le jayenge wala khet wala cover.
But it is a very very interesting cover because normally jab bhi kabhi epilepsy ke bare mein books hoti hai to wo bahut hi depressing cover hota hai.
Yeah, I wanted something very, very interesting. Yeah, I wanted something very interesting, something bright.
So, what exactly did you tell the publisher or फिर the designer ki?
Designer. Yeah.
Yes. So, what was the description that you gave to that designer while designing this cover?
I told the designer. I said, "Beta, आपने his name is Sumesh." I spoke to him directly. I said, "Dilwale Dulhaniya, dekhi hai? Is his hand dekhi hai?" I said, "Wo khet pe Shahrukh Khan bhagta hai na, pile pile khet par." I said, "Us pe aise dekhna ki jaise wo khet pe bhag raha hai, uske piche butterflies bhag rahi hai." So I said, so he followed. So he gave me some pile pile khet, and I said, "Is pe butterflies phenko bas." But butterflies should be of different purple color, red color, and all. So we designed it like that. But I said, in the title, I need epilepsy. Because the word epilepsy needs to be picked up in Google.
Google, correct.
So
correct.
That's why I said it needs to be colorful.
So now, where can we buy this book? Where can, matlab, mujhe to copy, signed copy mili hai. I have a signed copy. But where can other people who want to buy the book, where can they buy it?
They can buy from Amazon, they can buy from Flipkart, and if anybody wants signed copies, they can always Paytm me or they can get signed copies from me. Otherwise, Amazon is there, Flipkart is there, or they can Paytm me for 250 rupees and they can get signed copies from me. Or if they want all my, that is through, if you don't mind, I'm saying through your platform, if they want all four copies, four of my books, signed copies, I made a package of 1,000 rupees, including courier charges. So they can, all my four books, signed copies, I can package them and courier them. If they can, you know, they can send me like that.
Like
so
that,
so they can,
yes.
On Facebook, they can message me and I can send them all my four books. I'm on Wikipedia, they can find me there also.
So for the audience, ye book 220 nahin, 225 ki hai. Preeti, 225, but it is
yes,
only
yes.
225 rupees. So 225 rupees, so hum aise bahar jaye to hamare aise nikal jate hain travel mein. So agar aapko epilepsy ke bare mein janna ho, struggle sunna ho, padhna ho, to bhai 225 ki baat hai, khareed lo kitab, padh lo hamare bare mein. है ना. फ्लिपकार्ट की और अमेज़न की लिंक मैं डिस्क्रिप्शन में नीचे ऑब्वियसली ऐड करने वाली हूँ. एंड हाँ जी, इवन विदाउट माय परमिशन, अगर एज प्रीति राइटली सेड, यू कैन कांटेक्ट मी एज वेल इफ यू वांट द बुक. आई विल फॉरवर्ड इट टू प्रीति एंड यू विल गेट अ कॉपी. डू नॉट वरी अबाउट इट. And I have a chapter as well in this book. She has so graciously taken my chapter as well. So I'm very, very happy about it. And I have been telling all my relatives as well, ki kharido, kharido, kharido. So Preeti, what is your next step when it comes to epilepsy? What are you planning on doing?
Well, I plan to just climb a mountain, go bungee jumping, and I want to travel alone.
That's
if my doctor allows me. Yeah, I want to travel alone because I've not been able to travel alone. That's what I want to do. I want to travel totally alone because no mobile, nothing, except I'll be in touch with my daughter because that's another milestone. So no writing for another 2 years. I'm like Amir Khan, you know, I short in height and I emerge after 2 years.
No, but the first thing that we have to do is we have to meet once there is a vaccine. मैंने चंडीगढ़ आना है क्योंकि मैं तो बहुत दिनों से वेकेशन पे ही नहीं गई हूँ तो मैंने तो वैसे एवी मैंने तो आना ही है क्योंकि मैं हरिद्वार और ऋषिकेश भी बहुत टाइम से नहीं गई.
Come and you stay with me and you, me and Sizzler, three epileptics will sleep together.
Yeah, yeah. सुबह सुबह पापा पिल्स एंड रात को पापा. So a parting word for the youth, like, you know, the youngsters who are recently diagnosed or even the old people who are recently diagnosed, jinko abhi tak epilepsy ke bare mein zyada tar jankari bhi nahi hoti kyunki bahut recent diagnosis hua hai unka. So jaate jaate aise logo ke liye aap ek kya sandesh denge?
Yes, I have come across youngsters, 27-year-old, suddenly अचानक उनको epilepsy diagnose हो जाता है. Suddenly I've come across 57-year-old suddenly diagnose हो जाता है बैठे बैठे, and they go in a state of shock. Life उनकी upside down हो जाती है. Please don't hide it, don't take it as a shock. I know it can be shocking. I'll just say one line: acceptance is the key. Just accept it. लिखी थी बस, लिखी थी, होना था. Accept,
hashtag,
yes.
Accept epilepsy.
Yes. It could have been cancer, it could have been diabetes, it could have been any other disease also. But it was epilepsy. Just because it is cancer, and cancer has become a fashion. You can, and you know, people are talking about it. You can't, you just don't think epilepsy is a stigma. भाई किसी को बताना नहीं है, आप बता सकते हैं, कोई बात नहीं. ये भी आप, there's nothing to hide about it. कोई भूत प्रेत नहीं आई आपके अंदर. Talk about it, share, you'll feel better. Call up our warriors, call up Ketki, call me, you'll feel better talking about it. It's okay, it's not the end of life, it's a part of life, it's not a complete life.
You have epilepsy, okay. You have epilepsy. Epilepsy does not have you.
Yes, it's just a small part of your life. You will overcome it. I mean, you will. It chalte chalte, tumhari zindagi ka part hai. Tumhari zindagi nahi hai. It's good. Don't stop your life. It's just like just a cup of tea in the whole day. It's not a complete day. Don't let it consume your whole day.
Thank you.
Live your life. Ek zindagi hai bhai. Ek zindagi hai, kal ho na ho.
I love this line of yours. It is like kal ho na ho. Preeti always ends everything with kal ho na ho, which I absolutely adore because it is a fact. Like chalte chalte, haan ji, kyunki chalte chalte insaan ko heart attack aake bhi to gir jate hain log. Matlab market gaye the sabzi lane.
किसी को भी हो सकता है. Embrace it.
So, Preeti, just tell me before we sign off. आपके कार्ड पे जो ये नंबर है, is this the same number to connect with you, especially when it comes to epilepsy?
No, it is another number. Another WhatsApp number is there. Should I give that?
Share it with me on WhatsApp. तो मैं description box में वो add कर दूँ.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Yes.
That.
सो फॉर द ऑडियंस डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में आपको अमेजोन की लिंक मिलेगी, आपको फ्लिपकार्ट की लिंक मिलेगी, जहाँ पे आप ये अमेजिंग किताब, क्योंकि मेरी तो ये मतलब मैंने जब पढ़ना स्टार्ट कर दिया, ऑफ कोर्स सेल्फिश हूँ थोड़ी सी, तो मैंने पहले खुद का उसका ऑफर है, ऐसे मैं पढ़ना शुरू कर दिया, बट आई गॉट इंटरेस्टेड एंड आई फिनिश द बुक इन लाइक 1.5 hours, that's it. So, आपको ये किताब कहाँ पे मिल सकती है, इसके सारे लिंक्स नीचे मैं डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में लिखूंगी. डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में आपको विकिपीडिया लिंक भी मिल जाएंगे प्रीति जी की, और आपको कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर भी मिलेगा, अगर आपको एपिलेप्सी है तो आप उनको वहां पे भी कॉन्टैक्ट कर सकते हैं. टाइम पास के लिए कांटेक्ट ना करें, ये बस मेरी दरख्वास्त है आपसे, ये ट्रोलिंग या टाइम पास के लिए आप कृपया मैसेज ना करें. अगर आप सीरियस है तो प्लीज मैसेज
क्योंकि 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 आई एम आल्सो अ फौजी एंड आई एम आल्सो अ सरदारनी, आई नो हाउ टू सॉर्ट आउट पीपल.
हाँ तो आपको तो मतलब पढ़ने हैं, अगर आपने अभी टाइम पास के लिए कॉल किया तो. Thank you so much, Preeti, for giving me your time. I know how difficult it is for us people with epilepsy, and we are shooting this, we are recording this in the night. So, hum dono ki aankhe, matlab people also have this myth, na? Because hamare medicines hum khate hain, tab hum thode drunk jaise dikhne lagte hain. So, public wo bhi baat karte hain ki kitne packed down hai, bhai, and you're like. दवाई खाई है पैक डाउन नहीं हो, तो वी गेट दैट स्टिग्मा एज वेल, लाइक यू नो ड्रगी कहाँ जाता है, बेवड़ा कहाँ जाता है, पता नहीं क्या क्या.
I call myself चर्सी.
अभी क्या करे, आंखें वैसी हैं हमारी, हम कुछ नहीं कर सकते. वॉक अ माइल विद आवर मेडिसिंस एंड यू विल अंडरस्टैंड हाउ डिफिकल्ट इट इज. So wrapping up, thank you so much, Preeti, for giving us your time and being here on this platform and encouraging and inspiring everyone.
Thank you, Ketki. Thank you so much. It was lovely talking to you. And you're looking gorgeous as always. And we are going to meet. We are going to meet when you're 80, 90. Usse beech mein milenge. When you're getting married, I'm going to come for your wedding.
बंदा ढूंढो, दोनों के लिए बंदे ढूंढो.
मैं भी ढूंढ रही हूँ. I am also finding. We'll get married together.
Done. बंदे मिलना मुश्किल हो गए आजकल. छोरियां मिल जाती हैं, छोरे नहीं मिलते भाई. So signing off. For all people out there, stay strong, keep fighting, and as always, stay happy, stay golden.